with NSC.
European market open in a little over an hour's time will provide more clues. Mr. Anant Bajaj is Joint Managing Director with Bajaj Electricals. He's joining us right now on the phone line. Mr. Bajaj, thank you very much for your time. Good to have you here. Okay, he's live with us. Apologies for that. Mr. Bajaj, thanks very much. Now, I want to start by asking you about how business is looking, sir. You know, last week, I spoke with the proprietor of Vijay Sales, who's a large white goods appliance store chain in Mumbai, in Pune, in Delhi, but mostly in Mumbai, pretty large in Mumbai. And I was sort of trying to understand how is the consumer sentiment really like. And the feedback from them was that across brands, across product categories, things are looking pretty slow. I mean, they're actually now back to, sentiment at least is back to pre-election levels, pre-general election levels. I'd like to start with a basic kind of broad answer from you on that.
Mm-hmm. Well, there are two parts to that situation which probably people like Vijay Sales and other modern format retail might feel that as a result of it being a larger footfall oriented business model. But when it comes to rural markets and the semi-urban markets, there actually we have seen a lot of improvement and in fact a lot of growth happening. And I think it's the markets which are largely saturated or in the maturity level, like say the Mumbai's or any of the metros. There you might see a little bit of slow growth to a sort of flat growth. But as far as the larger piece of smaller markets, be it the, what we call as rurban or rural markets, I mean, those are where actually it's growing very well, and we have not seen a drop in sentiment. In fact, we've seen an increase of sentiment at the grassroots levels. And some of the larger markets may definitely not see that same kind of pattern which they have used to over the years. And clearly with the erratic monsoon and summer sort of playing jugalbandi with each other has also made an impact on the sentiment of should I buy a fan, should I buy an air cooler, because it's neither too hot, neither too cold, because every day something is happening with the weather in that sense. So clearly these, the seasonal products are definitely having a bit of a lukha chuppi, if you call it. But really, if you look at the larger products which sell throughout the year, be it thing like irons or for that matter even something like mixers, we have actually seen an increase in our demand. And in our case, we have actually, with the changeover to a secondary focus, I think that has made a big difference to us, because we could actually see a lot of market which never sold a lot of our products are for the first time actually selling it. So I don't believe personally for Bajaj Electricals it has impacted yet. Yes, but because after all, Vijay Sales is also one of our large customer, and there we would definitely believe that the kind of customers probably which come at the all these modern format, they might clearly be coming to some extent less because they are largely urban markets, but the non-urban markets are clearly on the growth level and they are clearly showing the path forward, because now with the various agriculture reform also potentially which might be coming, people have that money in the pocket to spend. And I guess urban, there have been certain changes in the way of living probably, which is affecting them to do a easier purchase than earlier. But clearly the markets have not gone. Maybe people who are used to a very large growth continuously, they won't see that growth right now. So to that extent, who are probably happy to see stable and consistent growth, I mean, those will be probably not feeling that same sentiment because it's like small incidents can't be made into a generalized situation. Yes, some markets may have a slowdown, but that does not mean that's a general situation for the whole industry.
Fair enough. So consumer products is one segment of your business. What is the percentage of, what is the share of consumer products to Bajaj Electricals top line and bottom line right now?
Right now, I mean, of course, last year was our turnaround year, so to that extent, it wouldn't be fair to use that as a benchmark. But I would, to give a larger benchmark, the company has roughly about 30% to 40% of its profit coming usually out of this EPC business, which obviously would be not true for this particular past few years, but that's what I'm saying as a historical thing. 30 to 40% of the profit comes from the EPC business, and roughly about 10 to 15% comes from the lighting segment, and consumer durables the rest of it. So it's a, and of course as a top line, usually over the years we have had a almost like a one-third in each of the three segments. So it's a well spread out from a top line point of view. But a bottom line point, clearly consumer durables uses a very low working capital. So to that extent, the ease of doing business in that segment is higher over a lighting or a EPC, because lighting again has some amount of working capital increase requirement as a resultant of being larger reach, because they are a distribution model which requires to reach out to many more places. So to that extent, and also the fact that they have luminaire part of the lighting segment, there is a lot of government business involved which requires more working capital to run, because although it supplies to government agency through the luminaire business, but in that case also there is still a requirement to give credit to the market, which takes a little more working capital. And of course EPC uses the larger part of the working capital. So clearly from a top line and bottom line, the spread is very evened out in that sense, and clearly this current financial year, with a lot of our earlier issues resolved, we should come back very strong. And clearly Q4 was a good example to show what we can really do as a company, because a lot of improvements have been made, which is there to see. August 6th is our board meeting, so we'll hopefully have good stuff to show you, which will be nice at that time.
Okay, fair enough. I got that. So, I mean, just to kind of recap, you said EPC is about 30 to 40% of the profits, consumer products is about 60%, lighting is about 10 to 15 odd percent or so. I mean, and you're saying that first quarter, you're giving an indication that first quarter should be pretty solid.
That's a general.
When the numbers actually, yeah.
Certainly.
Yeah, okay, fair
and
enough.
And main now, thing is that, and just what I gave you the numbers is a general trend over a large period.
That is what I was looking for, sir. So that helps. In consumer products, which are the sort of, you know, appliances and others, where are you seeing the most traction? When you said that semi-urban, rural, basically non-urban is doing very well. But which product categories are we talking about?
Largely it's the mixers, the sub-economy fans. And then we are talking about our induction cookers, some of the new one which we have just really, introduced, as well as a lot of the irons, which are the steam iron as well as the dry iron, are doing very well. Plus we've got a situation which is doing it's starting to do well for us, is pressure cooker, which we had not focused earlier enough. And thing like gas stove, these are some really growing areas for us. I mean, there are a lot of very, very good competition which we have in each of these products, but these are where we have done really well. And of course, with this whole secondary rollout which we have done in terms of reaching out to the last person. In fact, we just now running a tertiary scheme for the consumer, for where with a water heater we are giving an LED bulb as part of the deal. Now, those are kind of schemes which are really making customers very excited about buying it, and we have actually introduced it only earlier this month, and in month of June, and I think we're already seeing some good success out of that. And basically the sweet deals is something which we have stopped really giving, and as a resultant of that, the discount which we give to the customer has reduced, but that has actually made consumer more actually happy in a way, because you may find it strange when I say that how can less discount make someone happy, but actually the reality is that we have given them the right price, so there's no reason to give a further discount in that sense. And that's where I think a lot of that consumer confidence has always been there. And to that extent, the fact that we are reaching out more to them is where the consumer is happy, because I don't think Brand Bajaj needed to be told so much to them, but the what was required was to reach out to them more, and that's made a big difference.
Yeah, okay. Okay, fair enough. So in the consumer business, just to kind of sort of talk about competition, and I'm reading from a report from Ambit, Ambit Capital, which, and let me just quote this para for you, and I'd like you to respond. They say that Sphere Hot, which is a top three brand in water heaters a decade ago, is making a comeback in the market thanks to recent appointment of Bajaj Electrical's former consumer head as a strategy consultant. It's got funding from private equity investors and leading domestic financial institutions. And Sphere Hot has already placed orders worth about 180 crores with Chinese vendors. It's also beefing up its senior management by hiring from the industry. And they're pointing to this, you know, and they're saying, well, this doesn't augur well for Bajaj Electricals, consumer business, the appliances business primarily. Can you respond to this, sir?
Mm-hmm. Well, Sphere Hot has always been a very strong company for a very long time. It's part of the Marloni Group, which in fact was the prime competitor for Bajaj in water heating. And actually, even today, they are the close second after us. I mean, so it's something, those guys are equally strong as us in water heaters. So there is absolutely no problem in that sense, because everything is easily possible. Someone who was somewhere else has joined them and could have added value. There's absolutely no issue, because we are trying to make sure that what we do it really well. Competition has obviously also got enough information on us on how they can do well for themselves. So we absolutely don't feel any problem in that, because that statement is obviously to the extent saying that they have hired people to make themselves better, which only is actually a testimony of how good we are in the market, that we can inspire our
they are looking at things, Mr. Bajaj, but
for people from the around us.
They are highlighting the risks to Bajaj Electricals because of competition from this company. That's what I wanted you to respond to. And of course, I mean, there are others in the market as well, right? I mean, Crompton has got a new tie-up with a leading Spanish brand.
Certain.
Crompton has sort of got new people for the consumer business.
No, sir, risk-wise, I don't see that as an issue, because by one person or few people joining competition, I mean, I can't ever see becoming a problem for the brand in total, because today I don't think our products sell because of a person. It sells because of the product being good, the being because we actually do what we say and not just say for the sake of it. So I think the confidence was nothing to worry by some, because of course people are always privy to give their opinion, but we're not really there to worry about that. Some people can classify risk if somebody has joined them and is landing up giving some consultancy, but I think that's something which ideally should be good for the market, because that means a better product will come to the market, which means all of us as an industry can become better, so which is wonderful. I mean, I would encourage more competition to give us those challenges so that we can become better. Because we
broadly
would
speaking,
love to
Mr. Bajaj,
see
has competitive
competition
intensity gone
which
up?
Actually is trying to make.
Right. No, broadly speaking, has competitive intensity gone
absolutely.
Up?
Absolutely. We have, I mean, the fact that from our side, yes. From us, we have been creating many better products which will keep us at the number one position, because I think it's always difficult to become number one, but to remain number one is even tougher. So that's something which is where I think probably the Ambit report thinks it from that point, ki it is a risk which may not keep you at number one in water heater. Because Ambit, of course, has had some of the best analysis on the company over time. And we clearly have this point actually even discussed with them in the past. So it's not something really of worry to us, because we have to do our thing correctly, and that should be the main thing to look into. I mean, it's easy to get work done, the reports, but that's something which is for people who don't know the business probably. In our case, it's perfectly in order. I mean, we've been a market leader in water heater for a very long time, so it's not something which is going to die down easily. And we do also have water heaters and Morphe Richards brands. So to that extent, we have two brands minimum to work with. So as a resultant, we do have a good market share, and more than market share, it's the variety and the confidence which people have on the product is very strong. So there shouldn't be a real issue at all.
Yeah, all right, fair enough. Got that. Mr. Bajaj, you said the first quarter when you report numbers in August should be good. Could you provide some more guidance, sir, for the full year compared to 15 for each of your businesses? How will 16 pan out?
What we had said in the con call and the first quarter, for the fourth quarter ending, so we're looking at 5,000 crores at the top line. And of course, at a EBIT level, we're looking at that being in the 12 to 15 level, which will, of course, depend on the eventual aspects of how business turns out. But clearly, our EPC business has done the full turnaround. So to that extent, I think Q1, you should see that difference coming up. Lighting segment has got the LED very well settled in. So to that extent, lot of good order books also in hand. So to that extent, the lighting business will do really well. And consumer durable had already done some improvements in their margin. So now with the secondary rollout, I think they will again also make a very, very solid impact on their overall detail. So I think 5,000 crores is a very much achievable aspect for us. And we're not trying to overstretch the speed of growth. But we want to do things, few things, but do it really well and make sure we achieve it this time. Because I think last 3 years, all of you have been very patient with us. Now you have to see the fruit of that patience. I mean, and to that extent, it's that larger guidance that I can give.
Great speaking with you, Mr. Bajaj. Good luck, sir. Looking forward to interacting with you after the quarter numbers.
Thank you. Thank you.
When you report them. Thanks indeed. That's Mr. Anand Bajaj, Joint Managing Director with Bajaj Electricals, with that perspective. 274.6 on the stock at this point. Let's take a quick